His Holiness Pujyasri Paramacharya of Kanchi granted me permission to make this documentary film on condition that it was going to be about the history of the Kanchi Mutt as a whole and not merely a biographical of the sage himself. I had the holy privilege of completing this film in 1991. We merely added a few shots of the Kanakabhishegam of the great sage, which was celebrated just shortly before he attained Mahasamadhi. With humility and devotion, I have great pleasure in presenting this decade-old documentary as part of the Swarna Jayanti celebrations of the Peetarohanam of our revered Jagatguru Sri Jayendra Saraswati Swamigal, who continues the 25 centuries of tradition of the Kanchi Mutt, leading his innumerable devotees around the world in what may be described as a lofty spiritual boat journey in the perennial river of Vedic wisdom.
Two extraordinary souls of the 20th century met in 1927 in Palakkadu, a small town in South India. Well known for his punctuality and most uncharacteristic of him, Mahatma Gandhi lost his sense of time and the conversation became long. Rajaji, later Governor General of Free India, who had been described by the Mahatma as his conscience keeper, got concerned about Gandhiji's dinner time. He politely intruded into the conversation and reminded the Mahatma. Gandhiji said, "The conversation I am having with the Paramacharya is my spiritual dinner today." He continued his dialogue with His Holiness Jagatguru Sri Chandrasekharendra Saraswati Swamigal, Shankaracharya of the Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham. 63 years later, in 1990, the spiritual head of the Tibetan Buddhists, Nobel Laureate for Peace, His Holiness the Dalai Lama, visited Kanchipuram and met His Holiness Sri Shankaracharya to exchange notes for the future of man on planet Earth. Apart from the moral leaders like the Mahatma and the Dalai Lama, political leaders, presidents and prime ministers rush to this sage of Kanchi to find solace. This man of God, in his austere hermitage, is the direct spiritual heir of Adi Shankara, being the 68th guru in a line of Shankaracharyas, an ascetic order which began with Adi Shankara himself. His Holiness Sri Chandrasekharendra Saraswati Paramacharya of Kanchi is 98 in the year of Christ 1991, when the 2501st birth anniversary of Adi Shankara, the founder of the monastic order, is being celebrated. His Holiness demonstrates neither magic nor miracles, teaches no shortcut courses to salvation. He has never indulged in politics, never aspired for temporal power. Like the attributes of the infinite Brahman described in the Vedas, it is easier to say that the Paramacharya is neither this nor that. To most of us, he is an embodiment of several millennia of spiritual evolution, compressed in one frail frame, living in our midst today as God's most graceful manifestation of supreme love, compassion, and divine radiance. In 1954, the great Acharya chose his spiritual successor. The young and dynamic 69th Guru of the Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham, His Holiness Paramahamsa Parivrajakacharya Jagatguru, Sri Jayendra Saraswati Swamigal. In 1983, the two Jagatgurus chose their next successor to be the 70th head of the Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham, the radiant Shankara Vijayendra Saraswati Swamigal. The image of this teenage ascetic takes us back to the founder of the monastic order 25 centuries ago. A youthful lad who was swimming in the river Churna at Kaladi village in what is Kerala today. The little boy Shankara was more than a mere prodigy. He had mastered the Vedas when he turned 8 years of age and was already well known as a mystic scholar in the villages around. His mother Aryamba could not prevent the son becoming a wandering ascetic. Tradition has it that a crocodile caught his leg and began to drag him into the whirlpool of the river. Shankara shouted to his mother that if she gave him permission to become a sannyasi, he would be saved. The mother relented the resolve, so did the crocodile, and Shankara was free from both, a spirit liberated to pursue its goal. However, he kept his promise and returned to Kaladi many years later, just in time to perform the last rites for his mother. Kaladi has her samadhi near the river. The Kanchi Kamakoti Mutt has a mission at Kaladi and a temple of Adi Shankara in his birthplace. As soon as he became a sannyasi, the young Shankara walked through a hazardous path of several hundred miles to the banks of the Narmada River in central India. Omkareshwar, a pilgrim center today, where the river flows ferociously, but otherwise time seems to have remained frozen over the centuries.
Kaveri kanal madayoho pavitre samagane sajjana taranaya sadaiva nandha tripure vasantam omkaranisham shivanekamidhe.
On the banks of the Narmada, in this cave, a great guru, Govinda Bhagavat Pada, was in meditation. To attract his attention, the boy Shankara stood near the cave and sang his praise, recalling the guru's previous birth. The astounded guru accepted the remarkable young man as a disciple and formally initiated him as an ascetic, sannyasi. In the very place where Shankara met his guru, the Kanchi Kamakoti Mutt has built a temple for the great Govinda Bhagavat Pada and for Adi Shankara. After a long stay with him, Guru Govinda Bhagavat Pada asked his divine disciple to proceed to the holy city of Varanasi and elsewhere, propagating the truth of Advaita. At Varanasi, Shankara began delivering discourses, which attracted a wide gathering of disciples. He wrote his celebrated commentaries on the Upanishads, Vedanta Sutras, and the Bhagavad Gita. Shankara traveled far and wide through Bharatavarsha, the Indian subcontinent. He established religious mutts in several places, such as Puri in the east, Dwaraka in the west, Rameshwaram and Kudali Sringeri in the south, and Badrinath in the north, installing his disciples as acharyas in each place. After these wanderings, Shankara reached Mount Kailash in the Himalayas and acquired by the divine grace of the Almighty 5 Spatikalingas. He returned to the plains and consecrated these 5 lingas in 5 different centers of worship. The Varalinga at Nilakanta Kshetra in Nepal, the Muktilinga at Kedarnath, the Bogalinga in Sarada Peet, Sringeri, the Mokshalinga at the Nataraja Temple in Chidambaram, and the Yoga Linga at the Kanchi Kamakoti Shankaracharya Mutt for worship by successive acharyas of his order. The Yoga Linga continues to be in worship at the Kanchi Mutt today, almost 25 centuries later. After his extensive tour all over, Shankara settled down at the great city of Kanchipuram. He ascended the Sarvajna Peeta at Kanchi and established the Kamakoti Mutt order, of which he himself became the first in the line of acharyas. Today, the Kamakshi Temple and the Kamakoti Mutt continue to be under the guiding spirit of the 68th, the 69th and the 70th gurus of the ascetic order, His Holiness Paramahamsa Parivrajakacharya Jagatguru, Shri Chandrasekharendra Saraswati, the senior acharya of Kanchi, Jagatguru Shri Jayendra Saraswati Swamigal, and Jagatguru Shri Shankara Vijayendra Saraswati Swamigal. Kanchipuram is an ancient city referred to as a city of great learning in Tamil as well as Sanskrit literature of the pre-Christian era. Shankara remodeled the city of Kanchi in the form of the transcendental Sri Chakra through the ruler of Kanchi. Adi Shankara himself consecrated the Sri Chakra with his own hands in front of the presiding deity at the Kamakshi temple. Kamakshi temple stands right in the middle of Kanchipuram. The main gopurams or entrance towers of all other major temples of Kanchipuram, whether in the Shaivite Ekambaranatha shrine or the Vaishnavite Varadaraja shrine, face Kamakshi at the center of the city. The deities from all these shrines during festival days go in pradakshina, circumambulation around the Kamakshi temple. It is here in the Kamakshi temple that Adi Shankara became a Jivan Mukta, attaining immortality.
abhaya varado daivata ganaha swamika naivasi prakatita varabhitya bhinaya bhayatratum datum phalam api chavancha samadhikam sharanyo lokanam tavahi charanaveva nipunau.
Apart from his bas relief images in the Bangaru Kamakshi Shrine and the Utsava Vigraha Shrine at the Kamakshi Temple. Indeed, Adi Shankara permeates the atmosphere of Kanchi everywhere. In statues, in bas relief motifs, in every temple, small or large. Because this is where he settled down after his whirlwind tours of India. The uniqueness of Adi Shankara is that he combined in himself a philosopher with a crystal clear exposition of metaphysics, a poet of exceptional literary caliber, a saint of total renunciation with radiant compassion for fellow beings, an adventurer who traveled the length and breadth of the vast subcontinent a few times, an organizer who established a monastic order that carries on his tradition today, 25 centuries later. A mystic who had a unified vision of the world. No wonder he is worshipped as an avatar, an incarnation of Shiva himself. What is Adi Shankara's metaphysical conception? The world's largest monolithic monument is the Kailasanatha temple of Ellora in northwestern Deccan. Here, an entire multi-storied temple has been scooped out of a single rock on a hillside. The deity and the decorations, the ambulatory passage, the walls, stairs and ornamentation, everything is part of a single rock from which they have been carved. Adi Shankara said,
on the everyday level of truth, the world is produced by the Creator and it goes through an evolutionary process. But on the highest level of truth, the whole phenomenal universe, including the gods themselves, are unreal. It is all Maya, an illusion, a dream, a mirror. Ultimately, the only reality is Brahman, the imperishable and causeless world soul. We are all part of it.
Even as each of these sculptures and decorations has an independent identity, but is yet an integral part of the great monolithic rock of Ellora, all the living and non-living matter and energy of the universe are mere manifestations of the one and only infinite Brahman. When Adi Shankaracharya, the first guru and founder of the Kanchi Kamakoti order, became a Jivan Mukta, Sri Sarvajnatmendra Saraswati reigned the Peetham for about 4 decades in the 4th century BC. The Guru Parampara of successors continued without a break as a great river of wisdom. The third in the line of gurus was Srimad Paramahamsa Parivrajakacharya Sarvajnendra Saraswati. Literary evidence shows that Sri Mooka Shankarendra Saraswati, who reigned from 398 to 437 AD as the 20th Shankaracharya of the Kanchi Kamakoti Math, was worshipped by his contemporary Sahari Vikramaditya of the Gupta dynasty. the 38th in the line of gurus, Sri Abhinava Shankarendra Saraswati, who reigned the Kanchi Kamakoti Math from 788 to 840 AD, was more known than most of his predecessors. He toured all over India extensively. His visit to Kashmir is referred to in the literature of that period. The popularity of this 38th Shankaracharya of Kanchi and his extensive tours created a confusion among several later day historians and biographers who mistook him to be Adi Shankara. Thus, many historians of the East as well as the West were misguided to give a wrong date to the great personality of Adi Shankara. The 43rd Acharya of the Math, Sri Ananda Ganendra Saraswati, was a contemporary of Rajaraja Chola in Tanjavur. Recently, during an excavation in Kanchipuram, archaeologists have found epigraphical evidence of the connections between the Chola Empire and the Kanchi Math during Rajaraja's period. Kamakoti Kamakshi manifested herself in the perennial flow of wisdom. Several copper plate and stone inscriptions of the 15th and early 16th centuries talk about the Vijayanagar dynasty's obeisance to Kanchi Shankaracharya. Inscriptions of the Sultan of Golconda near Hyderabad, Abul Hasan, show how the sultans and nawabs in different areas of the country paid their respects to the Shankaracharya of Kanchi. The 65th Shankaracharya, known as Ilayathangudi Swamigal, visited Madras city and camped during the early part of the 19th century. East India Company records show how the company referred to him on matters of religion and respected his opinion in settling disputes. The 66th Acharya, Sri Chandrasekharendra Saraswati, inaugurated the Advaita Sabha in 1894 to propagate Advaita philosophy and to get together Advaita scholars from all over the country. His successor, Sri Mahadevendra Saraswati, reigned in the Kanchi Math for a very brief period in the year 1907. When he attained Siddhi, that year, the divine choice of the successor pointed to a 13-year-old boy, Swaminathan, son of Subramanya Shastri. The boy had moved up ahead of his age in his school at Dindivanam, where he won a prize for his portrayal of Prince Arthur in a student's stage production of Shakespeare's King John. When a bullock cart brought him to the Guru's camp, who could have thought that this boy would guide the destiny of the Hindus during the eventful 20th century? Swaminathan was quickly installed as the 68th Shankaracharya and became Srimad Paramahamsa Parivrajakacharya Jagadguru Sri Chandrasekharendra Saraswati Swamigal. Within 2 years of succeeding to the Peetham, His Holiness began touring the nation in the tradition of Adi Shankara. From that time to this day, 83 years later, he maintains with equanimity and ease a level of austerity which would be self-punishing for any normal mortal, with his extraordinary grasp of men and matters, giving darshan and talking to his devotees from multifarious walks of life. In 1919, when he was just 25 years old, the Paramacharya set out on a 21-year journey, sometimes walking through dense jungles, sometimes accompanied by hundreds of devotees, sometimes traveling with a small retinue of his immediate disciples. During his tours, he was met by many celebrated leaders of the Indian freedom movement, such as Deshabandhu, Chittaranjan Das, Satyamurthy, and others. In the midst of weak-kneed cautioning by some followers, he spent time with hundreds of volunteers of the freedom movement and gave them his blessings in their non-violent path. As a mark of his association with the nationalist movement, in the 1920s, the Acharya began to wear only khadi, a tradition which he has maintained all along. In another gesture of goodwill to freedom fighters, when he was passing through West Bengal, he gave darshan and blessings to over 100 political prisoners who took special permission from the jailer to come out of the prison, walk a few miles and have darshan of the great Acharya. At the invitation of Pandit Madan Mohan Malaviya, the Paramacharya visited the Banaras Hindu University and addressed the students and staff. His Holiness is known for his extraordinary memory. There are hundreds of true stories of devotees turning up to have a darshan of His Holiness after a gap of 20 or 25 years and finding to their great surprise that His Holiness not only remembers the individual devotee but also his father and mother, grandfather and grandmother, making kind inquiries about each of them. As much as he can discuss astronomy with an astronomer, philosophy with a philosopher, arts with the artist, the Acharya listens with patience the mundane problems of the householder, about the strains facing a family, the education of a ward, and the marriage of another. For each of these hundreds of thousands of men and women, it is like meeting the affectionate and divine eldest member of the family, as graceful and affectionate as God alone can be to man. The Paramacharya appointed special representatives of the Kanchi Math to tackle the task of renovating temples, which were languishing for want of support. As a result, a large number of temples were renovated. In 1944, he brought into being the Veda Dharma Paripalana Sabha to revive interest in Vedic studies. His Holiness Jagatguru Sri Jayendra Saraswati Swamigal has been the head of the Math now for several years, taking over from the Paramacharya not only the daily puja of the Guru Parampara, but also the entire responsibilities of administering the Math. Emerging as a tireless crusader for the perennial values of Hindu Dharma, His Holiness has travelled extensively through the length and breadth of India many times. Children are thrilled by his unassuming role as a simple religious teacher, for he finds time for them in the midst of his own penance and the enormous responsibilities of being the guardian of a 25 centuries old monastic order. There is no ostentation at all at the Kanchi Kamakoti Math. The religious observances are performed with devotion and austerity, sans glamour, sans showmanship, but full of profound spiritual ambience. In April 1991, concerned with the deteriorating communal tensions in India, His Holiness led a Sarva Dharma Padayatra procession in Madras and addressed an interreligious meeting, giving a sense of direction to his millions of followers and disciples. In his esoteric and poetic work, Saundarya Lahari, Adi Shankara says,
Japo jalpa shilpam sakalam api mudra virachana gatih pradakshinya kramanam asanadhyahuti vidhihi pranamah samveshak sukham akhilam atmarpana drasha saparya paryayastava bhavatu yanme vilasitam.
O Divine One, may it be that whatever I prattle, I am praying to you. Wherever I toddle, I am walking around you. Whatever my hand gestures, I am saluting you. Whatever my resting postures, I am prostrating before you. Any food I consume are oblations to you. All pleasures I pursue are my yoga to reach you. The Kanakabhishekam of the most revered Paramacharya as part of his birth centenary celebrations was a historic event in the annals of Sanatana Dharma in recent centuries. After His Holiness Sri Chandrasekharendra Saraswati attained Mahasamadhi, the 25 centuries old radiant torch of ancient wisdom is carried forward by Sri Jayendra Saraswati Swamigal and Sri Shankara Vijayendra Saraswati Swamigal, Acharyas of the Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham.